let's hope it sends what's been a very, very successful tournament off in a blaze of glory. It's always nice to finish a Grand Slam event with a great men's final. Drew McMillan alongside me, David Mercer. Best of five sets, of course. Tie breaks in the first four. Clément to serve.
First set, Manuel Clément to serve.
That's a good positive start.
15 off.
Clément won the spin of the coin, elected to serve.
Well, you couldn't have wished for a better start. The love service game. And if he is nervous, and surely he must be, that would settle them pretty quickly.
Yes, as I was saying earlier, this business about having nothing to lose. I think when you reach a major final like this, you have a lot to lose. There's a lot of pressure. And of course, pressure is what players go out there to, in a way, to seek, because they know there's going to be pressure on the big stage, and it's how they are able to rise above it. And that's a fine start by Clément.
Andre Agassi to serve.
Noticeable too, just as the players attempt to make their mark on the court, so do the various supporters tend to vocalize rather early on.
Well, there's the litmus test, the backhand down the line. It was a key shot for Capriati yesterday.
Extra weight of shot just telling there for Agassi. And Clément rather brutally having to stretch across. That'll remind him of his long match. Interesting to see whether players use the same balls or not that have just been a let. Most will not, and Agassi certainly not. Probably now hopes that he had.
The other thing we'll be looking out for is Clément and his spectacles. Remember, he took them off in the last two rounds, both played under the roof.
Yeah,
they were fogging up too much, and Clearly steaming up a little bit right at the start. He's a man who sweats profusely on the forehead.
Characteristic blowing around the court. He's a bit like a whale out in the ocean.
Perilously close.
Well, it's not often you see Clément serve volleying. Not a natural serve volley, but this was played rather well. Probably something discussed, just to break up Agassi every now and again, do the odd serve volley.
Putting a lot of effort into these early exchanges.
30-15.
Well, this is the big shot in the Clément repertoire, the into-out forehand. It's the shot that turned the match round against Grosjean. Agassi quick to his mark. He may have to get used to, he's played Clément enough to realize that Clément does take his time. The tiling down, cleaning of the eyes, the glasses.
Second ace from the Frenchman.
Served just 8 in his 5-setter against Grosjean.
So, first double fault now for Clément. Yes, he's allowed 20 seconds between points, this being a Grand Slam event. And he often uses them.
I think the wrong shot played. He should have been looking to play down the line. There was a lot of open court.
And Agassi has the first break point of the final. Yes, good stuff from Agassi. And he stamps his authority on the match early, taking the break and taking a lead of two games to one.
Sports car performance. SUV power. All-wheel drive does both in style. Double your fun with Subaru all-wheel drive. Subaru. And twirl, kiss and cry. The European Figure Skating Championships Gala, Sunday, 2000 CET on Eurosport. Brought to you by Metabolite. Now back to the Australian Open.
Discover the universe of tennis with BNP Paribas, the bank for a changing world.
View of the skyline of Melbourne. See from the cranes that it's a rapidly rising skyline. And Andre Agassi's stock is rising. Up a break, 2-1.
Yes, I like the way he finished off the last game. Agassi really grasping the opportunity with two hands. Clemard seemed to me just a little shaky on the serve and certainly miscuing a couple of backhands.
Clemore finds the backhand down the line. He did well to win that point because Agassi was playing ominously well.
He was, and playing inside the baseline and having pushed Clemore back. Clemore, who likes to take the ball pretty early as well. Small man, of course, doesn't want it to bounce up or bounce to the side too much, so likes to take it early.
Too much time to think about that. Yes, this is a small Grand Slam final with two men under 6 feet. Agassi at 5'11", and Clemore 5'8", 1m80 and 172. Incredible angle.
That's an unreal shot, isn't it? Even by Agassi standards. Driven back, and yet gets this precision.
Agassi leads 3-1.
So Agassi consolidates the break, and so important now for Clemore to hold, because Agassi gets away, he's a great front runner, and all the pressure will increase on Clemore.
Oh, that is just a brilliant shot. Riding it so well, Clemore attempting to jam him.
this is getting a little worrying for supporters of Clermont.
I suppose they'll say, well, look at what happened against Grosjean. But against Grosjean, they just couldn't get his act together at all, whereas here he's actually looked a little better initially.
That'll help. Third ace. Crowd clearly want Clermont to make a match of this.
Well, he's doing well to resist because Agassi's throwing the kitchen sink at him.
Forcing him into a strategic retreat.
Yes, I want to stay at the net and get burnt by one of his ground strokes. Well, the wide serving proving invaluable.
Two men out there who are quite fussy about the ball kids, where they take up their positions.
It's not that his two-handed shot down the line is necessarily a winning shot. It's a shot, though, that can open up the court, as we've seen with Agassi, who's been hitting his well.
Advantage, Agassi. Well, that's irresistible. So early, and it's a point for the double break. Very wide. Let's skid it off the line, and Agassi has the double break and has control. 4-1 in the first set. Well, he's come out here all guns blazing.
Yes, it's been a very fine start by Agassi, there's no doubt about that. And of course, the ominous signs for his opponent are not that he's not got the resistance, Clermont, but the point is he had that long match, I know it's 2 days ago, and just the thought of having to do it again, oh no, if I'm a set down, if I'm two sets down, the likelihood is it's not Grosjean he's playing, it's Agassi. And Agassi, it seems to me, is just reminding him every opportunity he can that I'm the boss, that if you're going to win this match, you're going to have to play miraculously well, because I'm going to snap at you at every opportunity.
How much of a factor is it that Agassi's had an extra day off?
Well, I think it's some factor. I mean, these majors are generally worked out pretty well, the US Open apart. I think it does help, undoubtedly.
Brad Gilbert and Steffi Graf. Part of Team Agassi, along with Gil Reyes, the physical trainer. And they'll be thrilled at the way he started. There's that into our forehand again.
Some reassuring two-handers there by Clément, who had really been miscuing them early on. One of his really better rallies.
So, three chances to recover one of the breaks. That's a way to take it. Debliker behind Philippe Rosson, the French Federation coaches.
Well, what a return. What a brilliant fight back by Clément.
The two games he's won, Clément, he's won both of them to love.
Perhaps sometimes a little, almost over-eagerness by Agassi. It's bound to happen when you're looking to get right on top and crush an opponent.
Second double.
Serves a few more doubles these days, but that's generally because he, like other players, is looking to bolster the first serve, hit it harder. And it generally is more rewarding for him. Got something to crow about, haven't they? The French.
Just wide. Yes, perhaps we ought to say cockerel about, given their national bird. Thank you. made that one, and he's won two games in a row. And the first set is much more interesting now. Agassi's lead is cut from 4-1 to 4-3, but he still has a break.
What gives broadband broader impact? Texas Instruments Programmable DSP. Technology that allows companies to provide internet access 100 times faster. The hardware and software behind wireless home networks. A digital fountain of youth that you can simply reprogram instead of retool and replace. From the world leader in DSP and analog, Texas Instruments.
Spin and twist, glide and twirl, kiss and cry. The European Figure Skating Championships Gala, Sunday, 2000 CET on Eurosport. Brought to you by Metabolite.
4-3 then, having been 4-1, and Agassi to serve. See, they've closed the roof just a little bit to give the players a little bit of shade at the back of the court. New ball's in play.
Lifting off.
And that's the best possible use of first ace.
Serve 10 of those, the aces against Pat Rafter. Tends to average these days, just a fewer amount of aces, a percentage number of aces less than his opponent, which is surprising.
So you think you've got a big into out forehand, do you?
Yeah, it's really getting on top of it. You see the weight on that right foot initially. Not a very long take back. He's not looking for the subtleties against Clément, is he?
No, he's looking for the early kill. I suppose everybody knows that Clément's very quick. 15. No sign, incidentally, of the left eye strain that has been a problem for Clément. So Agassi restores order, having lost the last two games.
Agassi leads 5-3.
And Clément must serve to stay in the set.
Well, one of the beauties of hitting the ball that hard is that the opponent really has got to make his move soon in order to get to the shot. And of course, Clément did there, and Agassi could see him out of the corner of the eye moving.
Found some incredible angles.
Well, it's huge tennis, isn't it? Some outstanding play. It's not all court, but then we didn't really expect it to be. Agassi against Rafter went into the net just about 20 times in the match, whereas Rafter went in 128 times.
Yes.
So we don't expect these two to go rushing in.
Help!
Another love game for Clément. He's won three now. Two on his own serve, one on the Agassi serve. But Agassi will serve for the set at 5-4. But I suppose the good news for you, for Clément, as we look at the statistics, he's doing much better on the forehand, is that he's now competing, whereas from the period when he was losing four straight games, he was being swamped.
Yes, and competing well, moving well, hitting out. I think that's one of the things he has to do against Agassi. He can't just rely on keeping Agassi out there, because in the process, of course, he'll get run into the ground. And I'm not sure whether he's got the stamina, really, over five long sets, even with a day in between his last match. It's also the nervous energy that players burn out there. It's one of the reasons why people really come unstuck. They sometimes, early on in a match, don't even have the strength to really put their full body and soul into shots. So at least heartening to see that he's able to do it with some big shots that he's played. Needs to work hard to hit a few more big ones on the backhand there.
Well, a lovely day to be playing tennis, a lovely day to be watching tennis. Needless to say, there aren't any spare seats to be had. 15,000 just over the capacity of the Rod Laver Arena. Record crowds yet again for the Australian Open. And Agassi serving at 5-4, opening set. Slightly late call. I think maybe Agassi was in the way. I think it was a right call, though. And that's not a great angle to look at it. Three set points. So Agassi comes up with his first love game of the match. And he has the opening set. 6-4.
Spin and twist, glide and twirl, kiss and cry. The European Figure Skating Championships Gala, Sunday, 2000 CET, on Eurosport. Brought to you by Metabolite. Now back to the Australian Open.
Discover the universe of tennis with BNP Paribas, the bank for a changing world.
An opening set decided in the first few games, really. That run of four straight games. More Agassi. Clément doing a lot better towards the end of the set. Oh, Andre's forgotten his cap by the looks of it.
Yes, it was a heartening recovery by Clément towards the end of that set, and that's how he's got to start the second.
Thank you.
Well, I don't know about his cap. I think he may have gone looking for his turbocharger, Agassi. My goodness. Clément looking a little stunned.
Is ominous. The last thing you want is to allow Agassi to jump on you at the start of the second set when he's already a set to the good. Could be a very long day in the office for Monsieur Clément. Well, the idea of drop shot and lob was not perhaps a bad one, but it was a lousy lob and wasn't a great drop shot. So Agassi's won 8 straight points and a very easy break right at the start of the second set.
Yes, an overwhelming start by Agassi, really looking so charged up, looking so quick about the court. And it's not often that Clément's been made to look a little pedestrian. But he's a man who can bite back. He has to do it right away here, as he, of course, did in the first set.
With the confidence to serve and volley himself now. It's a relief for Clément after losing 10 straight points. Well, I suppose at least it could be said he was going for that, and he didn't miss it by much. If he could make a few more like that.
Well, it's an important strike for him, coming very close with the preceding one down that part of the court. Just modifying his shot.
Second ace from Agassi, and it's the second game for him in this set.
As he leads 2 games to love.
knows all about being runner-up, of course, Agassi. Five times he's lost in the final. It's spare a thought for people like James Scott Connors, who lost seven major finals, not to mention Yvonne Lendl, who lost 11.
Fortunately, they managed to win a few along the way. Can you imagine losing 11 Grand Slam finals and never winning one?
Good call. And it's not been a feature of this Australian Open. The calling, in fact, I think has been comparatively poor. A lot of foot faulting, of course, as well.
A fifth ace for Clément. That's what we get for Philippe Rosson. Yet another love game for Clément. There's been an awful lot of love games in this match so far.
Agassi leads 2-1.
But it's Agassi who leads by a set and 2-1.
Greifen Sie jetzt zu. Sichern Sie sich das neue Nokia 3310 mit Zubehör. Rufen Sie jetzt mobil direkt an. 0180 1 4 mal die 0 1 5. Erhalten Sie dieses Superset inklusive Ledertasche, Autoladegerät und persönlicher Freisprecheinrichtung mit dem Time and More 20 Tarif von E+. Dieses Spitzenhandy hat SMS mit über 450 Zeichen, Vibrationsruf und integrierte Antenne. Lieferung in 48 Stunden Freihaus mit 14 Tagen Rückgaberecht. 49 Mark Anschlussgebühr sind frei. Der Preis? Dieses Superset kostet 0 Mark. Bestellen Sie jetzt, dann entfällt der Grundpreis bis zum 31. März 2001. 0180 1 4 mal die 0 1 5.
You've awakened to the true power of e-business. Do you have the software to manage it? If not, consider this your wake-up call. Software manages more e-businesses than anyone else on Earth. Hello, tomorrow. We are Computer Associates, the software that manages e-business.
Nicht vergessen, das Nokia 3310 im Superset-Angebot kostet 0 Mark. Jetzt zum Ortstarif anrufen und sofort bestellen. 0180 1 4 mal die 0 1 5.
That's a lovely arena, this one. The Rod Laver Arena, how appropriate it should be named after the Rockhampton Rocket, who I think is the best player of all time, even though Mr. McMillan always disagrees and says Lou Hoad, but I never saw Lou in his prime.
No, only on potential,
yeah.
Certainly not on results.
That's the lovely sort of argument we could all have over a glass of wine at night, or bottle of beer or two, or I suppose down here in tinnies.
Yes, once again, it's Agassi right near the baseline, and Clément getting a bit further back even, which doesn't suit him. Had he been closer, that backhand would have gone over.
14-15.
That's a really wasted opportunity.
I should say, what a great point.
Oh, quite magnificent, surely the point of the match so far. Simon been run from side to side and finally finding it. Wasn't that a clever lob that he played, that high ball off the forehand?
Game magazine.
Pity. Point like that deserved to be followed up by another one. And I thought when the plane started droning over that the French paratroops were coming over the hill just in time. But maybe not.
Seeking his shade. Covered a lot of ground. Agassi generally able to sustain the rally, whereas Clément is playing one or two fine shots and then just breaking down every now and again. Needs to keep it going a little longer as he did in that last game. I say that is that we've seen Agassi, seen his game break down even from in moments where he's looked so good or in matches where he's looked so good, and sometimes just for no rhyme or reason he cracks.
A third double fault.
I think particularly of Agassi's match against Kuchera at last year's French, where he was on top of the Slovak. And suddenly it disintegrated.
Another example of the both feet off the ground, backhand. No real problems. 2 points for the double break.
13-14.
And that's the first break point that's been saved in the match. Shooting yourself in the foot. Two doubles in the game. And you begin to think he can kiss goodbye to set two. Andre Agassi, two breaks of serve up at 4-1.
Don't ever stop.
Coca-Cola Life. Just what I want.
Kiss and Cry, the European Figure Skating Championships Gala, Sunday, 2000 CET, on Eurosport. Brought to you by Metabolite.
Andre Agassi firmly in the driving seat. Set to love, 4-1, two breaks, and seemingly motoring towards another Grand Slam title, the seventh. Clément. Clément. Came away with a miraculous escape against Grosjean, but it's asking an awful lot to do it again against Agassi. Good play, and he's got to find a way of raising his game like that, point after point.
Yes, a rally into the 20 strokes, and this is what I was talking about Clément. He's just got to lengthen them to enable himself, to give himself that opportunity. It wasn't a case, of course, of Agassi breaking down there. Agassi stood his ground.
Solid volley.
30-15.
And when I say Agassi stood his ground in that long rally, I was just watching him how he did with Clément really having to scrape and roll about from one side of the court to the other. There was very little movement from Agassi. He always seemed to be in the right position. Again, it was in the right position, was dictating, and yet Clément held on just long enough to take over. Pretty open and vulnerable to that serve, particularly on the first serve. I think actually stands just a little too far back, giving Agassi a bit too much scope for the swinging serve.
He continues to win the points that really matter. Moments of resistance from Clément, but the game score ticks ominously on and on for Agassi. Inquiring whether they're new balls. They are. 16 games completed, so it's the third set of balls coming out. Five double faults, a few choice words in French to himself. And that's a choice shot.
Oh, wow, this is just climbing all over it.
By much, and boy did he middle that again.
Juice.
And he just can't afford any unforced errors. He's having to live off scraps from the table. Good serve. Opened up the court.
Yes, I think he can use it just as Agassi can use his invaluably. He could use it a bit more often. Just looking at Clemon's racket head, a lot of wasted advertising space, isn't there?
Yes, no doubt his advisors will be trying to find him a new contract or two. In view of his new status, but at the moment his problem is not like a sponsorship, it's Andre Agassi, a set in 5-2.
What helps create wireless home networks? Texas Instruments Programmable DSP. The hardware and software behind wireless technology. From the world leader in DSP and analog, Texas Instruments.
Spin and twist, glide and twirl, kiss and cry. The European Figure Skating Championships Gala, Sunday, 2000 CET on Eurosport. Brought to you by Metabolite.
Opportunity to stretch the legs, like John Dunningham from the All England Club in the President's Tribune there. And Andre Agassi about to serve for two sets to love.
Thank you. 15 love.
Third ace.
Sampras out here. And there's that wide serve again.
I guess he served out the first set to love, and it looks as if he may do so again. Three set points. Three aces in the game. And Brad Gilbert on his feet. As Agassi takes a two sets to love, love lead in no time at all, really. Very impressive. Well, I have to say, Fru, if Clement comes back from here, I'll eat your hat.
Yes, it would be quite some story. Of course, Agassi himself came from two sets to love down in the final at the French against Medvedev. But Medvedev, of course, had never won a major before. Agassi has, and I think the taste of it is so appealing, it's going to be a very difficult job to break his hold on this one. The winners of Clément have got to be far in excess of that. And the unforced errors from Agassi outweighed by his winners. High serve percentage, and it's not as if he's just rolling it in, whereas Clément, who's looking to do perhaps even a bit more with his, way down at 50%. His serve has been a little shaky, there's no doubt about that. Sign of nerves to me. The backhand too of Clément has not worked well. He's jerked it a bit. Again, a sign of nerves. It's the old story, as I was saying before the match, where a chap coming into territory he's never been in before. He's beaten Agassi, but it's not in a major like this. And so many people just do not know how to win here. And of course, when you weigh up on the other hand, Agassi playing so well, the task becomes even more difficult for Clément.
So Arnaud Clément has very wisely changed to a red shirt. I'm all in favour of those. Just hope the red shirts do rather well next weekend, a small rugby match with the old enemy from England at the start of the Six Nations. Meanwhile, the start of the third set. Oh dear. At the start, Clément would have wanted.
Well, I was saying Wales from the word go, because he occasionally sounds like one of those.
A little bit of a nightmare for Arno.
Well, you can see he really didn't get under that. He was in a position really to play the high forehand volley, not the smash.
Three break points, and it's beginning to be a rout.
Agassi playing the low ball here. Clément too far back, and even here Agassi not looking to be clever, not looking for the wrong footer. He sees the opening, realizes if he hits it well enough, he'll win the point. Practiced his service action before the serve, didn't seem to help.
Oh, 13-14. Well, if he could just get out of this situation now, should give him some heart, but he's still got one break point to save. He's very wisely letting it bounce.
Yes, and that seemed to be the murmuring of the crowd saying just that.
So love 40 back to Juice. Great stuff.
Advantage Clemence.
And I'm sure the crowd wondering whether they're about to see another Clemence miracle here. One of the longest rallies of the match. I made it about 23 strokes. And telling blows too, and yet all resisted.
Shame. Almost the easiest shot he had in the entire rally.
Yes, I don't think his lungs were too full of oxygen as he went to play that. He just seemed to collapse a little bit, having opened up the court so well. Another really telling rally. Strenuous.
Number six.
He's really feeling it.
Yes, this now the longest game of the match.
Yeah, some of the longest rallies. And where he generally has been able to stand up pretty well to them. Twice, I think, just caving in.
It's grueling watching, let alone playing.
Yes, I'm surprised he's not asking for the oxygen cylinder rather than the towel.
So a fourth break point of this game.
What a creamy shot this is. Not to get into a long rally again. Have a go early on, and that's the shot I like to do it most with.
Super stuff. Put the game away though. It's so important for him to do so.
There's nothing ultra subtle, is there? It's all pretty bruising. All the more important, therefore, to win it.
Six double faults.
And I think it's certainly just lack of wind and lack of control of the body that's causing a double fault like that, causing the serve just to crumble a little.
Yes, he put heart and soul into that game. He ran for everything. He saved four break points, but he still lost it.
Absolutely, and the sort of finality in David's voice there, I'm sure that's the bruising feeling that Clement now has, because as I was saying, you put so much into it. It would have applied to both players, but of course particularly the man who's lost his serve and who now is two sets to love and a breakdown. A real shock to the system. He knows he can fight back, as he's done against Grosjean, as he's done in other matches, but two sets of love in a major final, well, doesn't often happen against a quality player like Agassi, who's shown his fitness levels against Rafter. Says a lot, doesn't it, for a 30-year-old. The last 30-year-old plus to win was Gomez against Agassi in the final of the French in 1990.
Final not only memorable for Andres Gomez, but for the Ecuadorian ambassador, who, if you can remember, who was in the front row of the presidential tribune at Roland Garros with the biggest flag you've ever seen. I don't think anybody sitting behind him saw any of the match.
Yes, it was a bit of a shock, that result, because most of us expected Agassi to win. Gomez, the left-hander from Ecuador, proving us all wrong, confounding Agassi. Oh.
Oh, yes. Well, he's still fighting. Great credit to him. And he's pulling off some fine shots.
15-13. And the backhand looking to be a little more powerful, a little more penetrative.
Two chances to break back immediately. Well, I have to say, Fru, that's the last thing I expected after that last game. The Klimov would come out and break straight back. Great effort.
Yes, I'm with you. Totally unexpected, and it wasn't all Agassi's own doing. Some terrific stuff by Klimov.
Missed it.
Well, there have been times, particularly in his match against Rafter at Wimbledon last year, when I really thought Agassi could volley a bit more often.
It's a good idea to leave a ball that lands on the line, Arno.
Kept chasing him there, didn't it? Like a boomerang. And right on the line it was.
So close. No, good call. Clemont in danger of undoing all the great work of the previous game. Two chances for Agassi to go up a break yet again.
Well, seeing them trading those two-handed backhands, a little one for you, David. Guess how many finals there have been between at the Australian between players with two-handed backhands.
Not too many. Courier, but he played Edberg. Great stuff. I mean, obviously last year, Legacy Kovalnikov.
Yes, not as many as one would think. In fact, it's only the fourth. Too big a point to discuss it right now, but we'll get back to it.
One thing Agassi hasn't done well in this set is take advantage of break points. He's converted on one of six so far. So now it's 2-8, and we start the third set with three successive breaks. And it's Agassi who leads by two sets to love and by two games to one.
Ready for the shave of your life. Map 3 from Gillette. It's so fast, so effortless. Three blades shave progressively closer. You take one stroke, it takes three. So you don't have to shave over and over. The result? Far less irritation. Three blades, fewer strokes, less irritation. Once you go to Mach 3, you'll never go back. Mach 3 from Gillette.
Now back to the Australian Open.
Discover the universe of tennis with BNP Paribas, the bank for a changing world.
Well, you said four times through. I mean, obviously last year, Agassi Kovalnikov Enquist, and what are the other two?
Yeah, no, only three times in the past. This is the fourth.
Oh, right.
The Kovalnikov Enquist, Agassi Kovalnikov, and in 1937, Vivian McGrath against John Bromwich.
Unlike you, I wasn't there. That's a sneaky one. Agassi, of course, trying to be the first man to hold serve in this set.
Just not quite high enough for Agassi to smash. He loves to take on that challenge to smash from the baseline.
Yeah, I was half expecting him to step in and play a drive volley off it. Ah, he had a feathered friend. Have to get out of the arena.
Maybe it's broken Agassi's concentration. Thinking of the pigeon that did damage last year.
Coach, then it seemed to be Clément for confirmation of the call.
Agassi just taking a bit longer here, using the towel. This is a big point.
So are we to start the set with four straight breaks?
Well, he didn't get much on the serve, and Clément able to take advantage immediately with the return, driving him back, and then the favoured shot of the Frenchman. Bad miss, because I thought Agassi was particularly gentle with his two-hand. I really didn't do much with it.
Start this to this third set.
Yeah, this is where the opponent against Agassi really takes encouragement. Well, if you can't build on that encouragement, of course, then it's in a way self-defeating. Unforced errors.
This is the most competitive passage of play of the entire match, these opening four games of this set.
It just waxes and wanes a little too quickly as far as Clément's concerned, though. If he can just build a bit more consecutively.
Third break point for Clément. Shot.
I thought Agassi was just losing a little bit of bite, but this rally certainly reaffirms his play of earlier on, taking the ball a little earlier even. Jackson.
And yet another long deuce game. Fifth time. Yes. And a fourth break point.
Well, a brilliant change of pace and of direction.
So close again. Just wide, and you wonder if that's the last throw of the dice. Four break points Clemence had, couldn't take them, and Agassiz becomes the first man to hold serve in the set and leads by 2 sets to 11, 3-1.
Yes, particularly punishing when you've won 8 points in a game on your opponent's serve and you haven't got a lot to show for it. I think the first time, too, that break points have actually been held in a match, in the match. That is without the loss of the serve in the end.
Yeah.
So two games in a row for Clément. Two games in a row in which he's put up a real fight and yet come unstuck. And of course we remember the first game of the set in which he did just the same. So he must feel like he's been through the washing machine.
Yes, and just maybe some of the strength is going out of the Clément legs. It's hard to drive them on and on and on when you're in this sort of situation. Seven doubles. He hasn't held serve in this set, and if he doesn't hold this one, I think he can say goodbye to the match.
Thank you.
looking to administer that final stroke.
It's wide. And surely that is that. Agassi up two sets to love, up four games to one, up two breaks to love. It would be a real miracle if he lost from here.
Toyota RAV4. Anders fühlen, anders fahren.
Wow, cool. Klasse, Papa. Mutti hätte bestimmt gekotzt.
Nichts ist unmöglich. Toyota.
Now back to the Australian Open.
Discover the universe of tennis with BNP Paribas, the bank for a changing world.
Andre Agassi surely set now to become the 13th man to successfully defend the Australian Open title. Jim Courier the last, 92 and 93. James Anderson the first, 24 and 25. In between, Jack Crawford, Frank Sedgman, Ashley Cooper, Roy Emerson, Ken Rosewall. Guillermo Vilas, who won it 2 years in a row on grass. Amazing. Johan Kriek, Mats Wilander, Stefan Edberg and Ivan Lendl.
Well, the Agassi backhand, rather ominously for Clemence, seems to have regained its bite. I thought the passage of the last few games, he played a few iffy backhands by his standards. Really wasn't getting on top of it. Wasn't hitting near the line when he was going down the line.
Well, after all the trials and tribulations of this set, in terms of break points and breaks of serve, Agassi would love a love service game. Going to get one. 14-15. Oh, sweet touch. And Agassi's one game away from a third win in Australia. And a seventh Grand Slam title.
Well, another brilliant backhand. Three we've seen in this game, and then just that lovely little feel and good hands at the net, which he has. Just, we don't see it quite often enough, perhaps.
Deciding it's time to show the complete range of his skills. Not that time. Miss Clemence hasn't held serve in this set yet. Feel that Agassi is quite content to let this game go past him and concentrate on the business in hand, surfing for the title.
Yes, I think a case of having a crack en route to serving. He wins the point easily. Fine.
Love game for Arnaud Clément. All love service games for him. But he's somehow got to break Agassi twice in a row if he's going to stay in the match at 5-2.
Well, he did it against Grosjean, but it's most unlikely that save match points, of course, against his friend and fellow Frenchman. But most unlikely that he's going to do it here. It'd be a great boost for the 30 pluses, as I mentioned earlier. Of course, Laver, when he won his Grand Slam, was 30 plus. And Newcomb, when he won the Australian in 75, was over 30. Ken Rosewell, of course, was, he did things when he was 33. Did things like win majors, I mean. I'm sure he did other things as well. Won the Australian in 72 when he was 37 years old. So Agassi could, if he wanted to, have seven more years in him.
Andre Agassi coming out to serve for a seventh Grand Slam title. He will join, if he wins it, the likes of Mats Wilander, John McEnroe, John Newcomb, René Lacoste and Henri Cochet, two of the great French musketeers. Richard Sears, William Renshaw and Bill Larned at the seven Grand Slam title mark.
One last touch of the talisman, perhaps, for Clément.
Lovely stuff. Well, he's making Agassi really work for it, and that's great.
Well, the talisman doing the trick. Needs to just rub it again. Marvellous stuff.
First ace of this set. Championship point for Andre Agassi. Thank you. Too good. And just like the women's final, the men's final ends with a backhand winner down the line. A comprehensive win for Agassi. He looked in command from the moment he won games 2, 3, 4, and 5 at the match. Clément, well, he can look back on a terrific tournament, but on the day, he was outclassed. Steffi Graf and Brad Gilbert celebrate their man's victory. Gilreis also in the picture. Agassi wins 6-4, 6-2, and 6-2.
Well, what a great feeling it must be, of course, for the Americans as well. Not only did Capriotti win, but now Agassi winning. He couldn't take it for granted. He knows that Clément can beat him. He had done it before, and yet he seemed to lay down the law from the word go. He seemed to boss Clément about, just reminding Clément that Clément played the more tennis and had the longer semi-final a day later than Agassi. And really, there were only one or two periods of play where it looked as if Clément might get back.
Da soll er rein. Und das kann verdammt hart sein. Handball, die erste Bundesliga. Live und exklusiv. Das Topspiel der Woche. Mittwoch ab 20.15 Uhr. Live nur im DSF. Hey, hey.
Eine Begegnung, die seit über 10 Jahren fasziniert. Für die meisten ist es das Spiel der Spiele, ein Traumfinale. Pete Sampras gegen Andre Agassi. Zum 30. Mal stehen sich beide gegenüber. Die erste Master Series-Veranstaltung endet mit dem Highlight. Agassi gegen Sampras, gleich nach der Werbung.
Herrschaften, gleich gibt's eine Aussicht. Sowas habt ihr noch nie gesehen.
Aussicht? Welche Aussicht?
Da oben, da müsst man rauf.
Hör mal, Meister, gibt's denn hier keinen Lift?
Genau, Lift-Apfelsaftschorle aus knackigen Äpfeln und reinem Wasser.
Oh, super Aussicht.
Lift-Apfelsaftschorle, immer schön Lift bleiben.
Mit T-Motion von TD1 gibt es einfach mehr online für unterwegs. So sind Sie mit einem TD1 Bump-Handy immer rechtzeitig informiert. Zum Beispiel über das Wetter. Oder das Neueste vom Sport. Oder andere wichtige News des Tages.
Alte Schwede.
T-Motion, das neue Webportal von TD1.
Steve, was hast du denn da Feines?
Schokoriegel?
Hey, warte, die wahrscheinlich längste Praline der Welt. Ich glaub's nicht.
Oh,
sind
die lang? Schmeckt ungewöhnlich leicht, fast schwerelos.
Für die einen ist es Duplo, für die anderen die wahrscheinlich schwereloseste Praline der Welt.
Träumen Sie nicht davon, fliegen Sie davon. Buchen Sie jetzt die TUI April Specials. TUI, Sie haben es sich verdient.
Eine private Krankenversicherung ist einfach ideal für mich. Gute Leistungen gibt es schon ab 200 Mark monatlich.
Ich bin sehr zufrieden mit den Leistungen meiner neuen privaten Krankenversicherung und zahle dafür nur 247 Mark im Monat.
Anrufen 0180 7x1 oder online www.curatel.de.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow, 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 follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the rainbow over the stream. Follow the fellow who follows the dream.
Follow the, follow, 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 follow the yellow brick road. You're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. You'll find he is a wizard, a wizard, never a wizard was. If ever, ever a wizard was, the wizard of Oz is one. Because, 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 because.